Hello. My name is TK, and I'm a robot. The following images and videos deals with a controversial subject. I invite our viewers to make their own opinion and judgment, based on all information available. Weapons of mass destruction. Part 2. Nuclear weapons, the fallout. On July 16, 1945, in New Mexico, scientists of the Manhattan Project readied themselves to watch the detonation of the world's first atomic bomb. The research and development of nuclear weapons during World War II was under the direction of Major General Leslie Groves of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and physicist J. Robert Oppenheimer, director of the Los Alamos National Laboratory, and designer of the bombs. During this race for nuclear power, trying to create the ultimate high-yield thermonuclear weapon, the biggest nuclear bomb ever was built. Nicknamed Big Ivan, and often referred as the King of Bombs, it was detonated on October 30, 1961, in an archipelago in the Arctic Ocean in northern Russia and remains the most powerful man-made explosion in human history. Developed by the Soviet Union, the bomb had a yield of 50 megaton of TNT, although originally designed to be twice as powerful. The mushroom cloud was above the stratosphere when it peaked. The heat from the explosion could have caused third-degree burns 100 kilometers or 62 miles away from ground zero. A shockwave was observed in the air 700 kilometers or 430 miles away. Window panes were partially broken to distances of 900 kilometers or 560 miles. It was decided that a full detonation would create too great a risk of nuclear fallout, as well as a near certainty that the release plane and crew would be destroyed before it could escape the blast radius. Did you know? Nuclear weapons can cause severe fallout contamination and can extend far beyond the blast and thermal effects. Much of this material falls directly back down, close to ground zero within several minutes after the explosion, but some travels high into the atmosphere. This material will be dispersed over the Earth during the following hours, days, and months. Predictions of the amount and levels of the radioactive fallout are difficult, because of several factors. The yield and design of the weapon. The height of the explosion. The nature of the surface beneath the point of burst, and the meteorological conditions, such as wind direction and speed. In 1983, Carl Sagan, along with four other scientists, physicists and researchers, published a report entitled Global Atmospheric Consequence of Nuclear War, which is the foundation of a theory called nuclear winter. Theory states that nuclear explosions will set off firestorms over many cities and forests within the range. Great plumes of dust, soot, and smoke would be sent aloft from these fires, lifted by their own heating to high altitudes, where they could drift for weeks, before dropping back or being washed out of the atmosphere toward the ground. These thick black clouds could block out all but a fraction of the sun's light, for a period as long as several weeks. The conditions of semi-darkness, killing frosts, and sub-freezing temperatures, combined with high doses of radiation from nuclear fallout, would interrupt plant photosynthesis and therefore destroy much of the Earth's vegetation and animal life. The extreme cold, high radiation levels, and the widespread destruction of industrial, medical, and transportation infrastructures along with food supplies and crops would trigger a massive death toll from starvation, exposure, and disease. In 2014, a group of scientists published an updated report about climatic effects of a regional nuclear war. It theorized global ozone losses of 20 to 50% over populated areas, levels unprecedented in human history, would accompany the coldest average surface temperatures in the last 1,000 years. UV indices of 30 to 80% over mid-latitudes, suggesting widespread damage to human health, agriculture, aquatic and terrestrial ecosystems. It is not certain that a nuclear war would produce a nuclear winter effect, but, according to Carl Sagan, one of the 1983 original scientists of the theory, concluded that the possibility of the extinction of human species could not be excluded.
That nuclear war certainly will destroy the nations involved in the nuclear war, almost certainly will destroy the global civilization, and might just possibly destroy the human species.
Did you like this video? Stay tuned.